हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द डीएवी मॉल पब्लिक स्कूल सीता सावंगी। आई एम योर कंप्यूटर टीचर। दिस इज स्टैंडर्ड 7, सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर। अवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर, पार्ट 2। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फर्दर जनरेशन, बट बिफोर वी गोइंग टू द फर्दर वी रिकॉल द प्रीवियस वीडियो। सो in the previous video we will discuss about the history of computing and the generations, what type of generations and what type of hardware is used in the different generations. So let's we discuss in previous video. In the first generation we will discuss about the vacuum tube, punch card and a paper tape, which is starting from 1940 to 1956. And in the second generation, which is starting from 1956 to 1963. In this generation, the transistors are used. Now we go to further. Now, in the third generation, it is starting from 1964 to 1971. It is used integrated circuit. That is, it's look like in images, the integrated circuits, and the use of integrated circuit use for second image, we see the using of integrated circuits of a computer. This is starting from 1964 to 1971. But in the third generation, we see the what type of hardware it uses. In the third generation, the hardware used, that is IC with SSI, that is small scale integrated, and MSI. The second, larger magnetic core memory, and third, larger capacity disks and magnetic tapes for secondary storage. And mini computers of words compatible family of computer. Each have some software characteristics, that is a time sharing operating system. Second, standardization of a high level programming language. Third, unbundling of a software from hardware. Now it has some features also. The first one is a faster, smaller and reliable, easier and cheaper to produce. Second, commercially easier to use and easier to upgrade than the previous generation system. And third, a scientific, commercial and interactive online application. So these are the features of a third generations. Now we're going further for a fourth generations. In the fourth generations starting from 1972 to 2010, in this generation the hardware used the microprocessor. A microprocessor, small type of chip. This type of hardware is used in the fourth generation. So let's see the what type of hardware used in the fourth generations. The microprocessors are semiconductors memory. Second, a larger capacity of hard disks, as in built-in secondary storage. Third, personal computers. Fourth, supercomputers based on a multiprocessing technology. Next, speed of high speed computer networks. Next, larger capacity main memory, hard disks, and optical disks as a portable read only storage media. Okay, and notebooks, powerful desktop PCs and workstations, and internet. So these are the hardware characteristics used in the fourth generations. Now we see the hardware software characteristics. It is a GUI based operating system. GUI is a stand from graphical user interface, which is user interface means when we use the softwares, it is a easily understandable by user. That is a graphical user interface. Next, multiprocessing operating system. Next, object oriented design and programming, and network based and super computing applications, and multi-threading distributed OS, another parallel programming like a Java. Now world wide web, multimedia internet applications, more complex super computing applications. So these are the software characteristics of fourth generations. Now it has some features also. Let's see. Small and affordable, reliable and easy to use PCs. Second, general purpose machine. Third, easier to produce commercially, easier to upgrade, rapid software development possible, portable computers, powerful, cheapest, reliable and easier to use desktop machine, powerful supercomputers, easier to produce, commercially easier to upgrade, rapid software development possible. So these are some characteristics, hardware characteristics, software characteristics and some features of the four generations. Let's again discuss about the fifth generation. The fifth generation is like now, beyond. The fifth generation is starting from 2010 to present and beyond. Let's discuss about that. In the fifth generation, some uses of some hardware characteristics like a superconductors, powerful servers, supercomputers, interspace, cluster computing. So these hardwares are used in the fifth generations. And it has some software characteristics. It's a natural language input. Now we see it in a Hindi language, Marathi language, English, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu. These languages are used in the computers for a typing and vocabulary. So these are the software characteristics of a natural language inputs. It has some features also. It is a voice recognition. Voice recognition means when we talk, they can easily search like a Google input, like a Google Assistant, which can so this way we can giving a voice command to our mobile computers by using Google Assistants. Now let's see further. Now the Tobo asks the teachers, what is the feature of technology? Then teacher says, tech trains. Tobo again asks, what is that ma'am? Then teacher says, tech trains innovating the digital era. It is a digital world. It can be a further future. Now the teacher says there are new technologies that currently developing or will be developed over the next 5 to 10 years. They are technological trends that are innovating in the digital era, like a robotic wearable devices, tech tats which attach to the skin like a temporary tattoo, mind reading machines, virtual reality or virtual world, artificial intelligence, big data cloud computing, Wi-Fi, wireless charging standard, technological advancement in a rural area. So these way we characterize generations of fifth generations. Hope you understand all the generations. Okay, thank you, have a nice day.